My name is Jacqueline. I'm a corporate flight attendant. Welcome to my channel, Jacqueline Travels. Today is not 100% flight attendant related. I'm actually going to film my pregnancy Q&A vlog. And a while ago, I had put out a video asking you guys if you thought I should have two separate channels here on YouTube, but you want everything condensed. You want all of my flight attendant life and my personal life in one spot. So here we are in one spot doing a pregnancy Q&A. Before we get into it, please make sure you're subscribed to my channel. This way you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Thank you guys very much for being here. I took notes of your most asked questions and I've been compiling them for a while. And I'm just gonna read off the notes that I have in my phone and share my answers with you. All right, the first question is, can you still fly? I know I have not put out that many videos of me working on the private jet, and that's not because I am restricted right now. It's just because there haven't been that many opportunities for me to work on the private jet. I have been going to the doctor regularly, and thank goodness it's been all smooth sailing. I've been healthy, the baby has been healthy, and I don't have any flying restrictions until I'm at my 36th week of pregnancy. And at that point, my doctor suggests that I just stay grounded and stay home and stay close to the hospital where I will be having my child at. So I still have a few good weeks left in me. If you guys are looking for a contract flight attendant, give me a shout. Okay, the next question, do you know what you're having? We do not know what we're having. We want to be surprised. And don't read into the pink. Just a coincidence that I did the pink lipstick, pink t-shirt thing today. Doesn't mean I'm having a girl. And there have been multiple times in my pregnancy where I have thought, this child is for sure a boy, or this child is for sure a girl. Truth be told, I think I lean heavier on thinking that I'm having a boy, and my husband leans heavier on thinking that we are having a girl. But his mind changes too. At any given time, we're just changing our answer. And I am kind of a type A personality. I like organization and planning, and I have my notes on my phone. I always have my notes when I'm vlogging with you guys. And when I got pregnant, I knew that I wanted to be surprised, but I wasn't sure if I would be able to. And honestly, it hasn't been hard. Like, I have not had any temptation to ask our doctor or to peek at the ultrasound when my ultrasound technician is telling me to look away. I just think it's gonna be so fun. Hey, Logan, this is my firstborn, my son, Logan. I just think it's gonna be so fun to find out what the baby is when the baby is born. We already know there's a baby on the way. We already know around when it's gonna come. And just having one more surprise in pregnancy is just really special and very exciting to me and to my husband and obviously to our families. Okay, question number three is baby names. And surprise, surprise, I have a whole list saved in my phone of names that I love and names that we're probably not gonna use, but that I still love. And I was actually thinking on recording an entire separate vlog about baby names because I've watched them here on YouTube. They were titled like baby names that I love and I'm not using. And like I said, I have a page for boy names and a page for girl names. And I think I'm gonna make that a completely separate video. But as far as does this baby have a name? Well, first we're gonna find out if it's a boy or a girl. We do have like our top names that we've thrown around, but neither one of us has said, oh my gosh, that's the name. This is what we have to name our child. It's perfect. I can't see living life any other way. Actually, I have my boy name picked out. I know the name 100% that I want, and I'm trying to get my husband on board with it. And it's a family name, not just my side of the family, but his side of the family too. So I thought it would be easier to convince him of using this boy name, but it hasn't been yet. I'm still holding on to hope that my boy name will be the boy name that we pick if we have a boy. Okay, next question, pregnancy cravings. If you guys follow me on Instagram, which is Jacqueline Travels, just like it is here on YouTube, you would know I eat the spiciest chicken wings 2 to 3 nights a week. I want chicken wings for breakfast, for lunch, and for dinner, and I want them really hot and really spicy and smothered in sauce. And truth be told, that is not like me. Before I got pregnant, I hated chicken. I was never a fan. I would make chicken cutlets and I would eat them, but I would never be super excited about it. Chicken to me is just a gross disgusting animal. I hate preparing it. I hate butchering a chicken, but I would make it because my husband loved it. But now it's all I can think about. Like, I don't even know who I've become. I just love chicken all the time. Okay, when did your pregnancy feel real? Honestly, I'm in my third trimester now. Like, the baby is coming in not that long. It still is like mind-blowing to me that I'm having a child. I will look at my husband Jonathan and be like, can you believe we're actually having a baby? And he's like, I know your stomach is bigger and I know we've done this much preparation and we have the car seats not installed because I know you can't install them too soon in case you get into a little car accident. But we've made preparations and we've talked about baby and my stomach is growing and it's still hard to believe that I'm having a child. I think the first time it felt real was when I felt the baby move and then when my husband got to feel the baby move. It was just like a very special moment and that was like the first physical connection that he really had with the baby. And it was special. Every time the baby moves, like, this kid is moving all the time now. I always joke that it's gonna be like a cardio kickboxing instructor. It feels real, but it's still mind-blowing. But it's mind-blowing in a good way. Like, we are very, very excited for this. Okay, nursery theme. I don't have a specific theme for the nursery. I don't like tons of pinks. I don't like tons of blues, so it was very easy for me to do a cream colored nursery. I can have a pop of pink in there if we have a girl, or a pop of blue in there if we have a boy. Personally, don't get offended. Do whatever you want with your children. I think a theme is, I don't know, it just doesn't go with my decor. I don't want to offend anyone. I don't want to say themes are tacky because they're certainly not. And it's not easy for me to plan a theme because I don't know the sex of my child. So it just doesn't make sense for us to have a theme. But I have a color scale and it's monochromatic and it goes with the rest of the house. You can see I have a dark brown accent wall in the back. I have these cream colored couches. I like neutral. I like cozy. I feel like it's just a good environment to feel comfortable in. And that's what we want to have in our child's room. So for my baby shower, it was virtual. And when I registered, I had a few animal, like baby giraffes, baby elephants, like a few animal blankets and crib sheets and things like that thrown in there. But I wouldn't say it's like a jungle theme or an Africa theme or safari themed nursery. It's just very neutral and bright and comfortable. And I have seen nurseries that are very cute that are themed. Again, it's completely a personal preference. Whatever you want to do with your child or your home or your decor, of course, is a personal preference. My preference was to just keep it kind of basic. And we want the kid to be able to grow with the room without having to drastically change things or paint colors or peel decals off the wall or anything like that. So the nursery is a clean and simple room that our kid can grow into. Do you want to have more babies? Well, I love having sisters. I think having siblings is the best. And I'm fortunate that me and my sisters are best friends. And my mom grew up as an only child and always talked about how much she hated it. And my husband is an only child. And I see how all of his family responsibilities fall on him. And I feel like that's a lot of pressure for someone to handle. So ideally, I would like to have another child. I would like to give this one a sibling. Let's see what it's like having one. Maybe birth is gonna be the worst thing ever and I'm not ever gonna wanna do it again. Fortunately, my pregnancy has been pretty easy. I suffer from like terrible heartburn, but it's manageable. I can still live my everyday life. And once I got past the first trimester, I stopped dealing with like the all day sickness. So would I go through pregnancy again? Yeah, I feel like it was easy enough to deal with and I was lucky and I'm happy that I was lucky. So if we're blessed enough to have another child, my husband agrees we would have another child. And if it doesn't work out, we're gonna be very happy with the one that's growing right now. Okay, the next question is, how did you tell your husband? And I did not find out before my husband found out. Over the summer, I had mentioned that I feel like I might be pregnant and he didn't think there was any way. And I said, all right, well, you know, I'll wait a little bit. Like, it's too early to take a test. If the lady parts don't start working like they're supposed to on schedule by a certain time, then I know it's time to take a test. And so he picked a date for me to go to the pharmacy and get a test. And I came home that night and called him into the bedroom and I peed on the little stick. I kept him in the bedroom for that part because some things should just be sacred. And I put the cap on the stick and we had 2 minutes to wait, 3 minutes to wait, whatever it was. And he said, "I don't think there's any way you can be pregnant." And I said, "No, I feel like I'm definitely pregnant." And sure enough, two lines showed up on that test and we just kind of looked at each other like, wow. And I cried. And he made sure they were happy tears, which of course they were. And then I think we just sat in silence for, I don't know, it felt like 5 minutes, but it was probably like 18 seconds, just because we couldn't believe that it was happening. And not to be like graphic or anything, we weren't necessarily trying, so that's kind of why we were surprised that it had happened. We had a date when we wanted to start trying, and we assumed that it would take time when we did start trying to have a child. So the fact that we were lucky and it happened instantly, I think was just a shock to us. The question after that is, how did you tell your family? Well, I took a picture of the two pink lines and I sent it to one of my sisters, the one who already has a kid. And I said, "You are sworn to secrecy. Don't say anything. I haven't gone to the doctor yet. This is brand new. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh." And her response was, "I swear, I just had a dream that we were both pregnant and you were having a girl." Well, it turns out my sister was also pregnant. We are only due 2 days apart. So we wanted to come up with a fun way that we could both announce it to our family. And we had gotten together over the summer and my sister was like, "Let's just tell mom and dad at brunch at their house." And I said, "Yeah, I think that's a good idea. It's an intimate setting. We're all dealing with coronavirus. Everything is closed. Like, we can't really have a big to-do or a party or a celebration or anything like that. Like, let's just do it in the comfort of our parents' home." And I think we're about to have mimosas served to us. And my sister, who already has a child, decided she would go first. And she said, "Well, I'm not gonna be drinking anything. And if anybody needs a sober driver, I'm more than happy to do it. I'm expecting baby number two." And so we were all screaming and we were all crying and we were all so excited. And when that all settled down, I said, "Oh, it's just so exciting that you're having a baby." I said, "If you need any backup being a sober driver since you're having a baby, let me know, because I'm actually also pregnant." And I don't think my family believed me for a second. Here comes Lola. "Hey, can you get down? Here, Scoochie's over." I don't know if we caught that, but I said, I don't think my family believed me for a quick second. And when they got over the shock, there was more screaming and there was more crying and there was more celebrating. And it was just such a fun moment. I wish that I could hold on to that feeling forever. And then the last question is, did you have any morning sickness? I had all day nausea. I did not ever get sick. I never upchecked. But in my first trimester, I cried almost every day because I felt awful. I didn't want to eat anything. I didn't want to smell anything. And because I couldn't really eat anything without like gagging or not feeling well, I had no energy and I was fatigued. And I just did not feel like a person. I felt like I could hardly function. The extent of my days were moving from my bed upstairs to my couch downstairs. And I had energy to go to the kitchen and drink some water and try to eat a piece of toast. But all food sounded disgusting to me and I wanted nothing to do with any of it. And then I got into my second trimester and I started feeling so much better, and that's when the chicken wing cravings really hit. And that's when I realized like everything has changed. My taste buds have changed, my body is changing, my preferences are changing, and I'm changing for the better and feeling like a human. Like, I'm exercising, I've been pretty active during my pregnancy, the later parts of it anyway, and now it's great. I'm still in the comfortable phase of trimester three. I know a lot of women say this is when things start to really go downhill. I haven't experienced that yet. I'm sure it's on its way, but for now, I'm feeling great. So those were all the questions that you guys had asked me. If you guys do have other questions regarding the baby on board, feel free to leave them in the comments section and I will definitely answer them for you. Thank you to all of you who let me know just to keep my YouTube channel one YouTube channel and not break it up into two different channels. Thank you very much for watching today. Please do leave me Logan, Lola, and the baby a thumbs up for this video. Please make sure that you're subscribed to my channel so you don't miss out on any future videos. And again, thank you very much for watching. I'll chat with you guys in the next one. Bye.